हमारे शरीर में।
आप लोगों को समझ में आ रहा है क्या बात बता रहे हैं? कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है तो ठीक। आप लोगों ने देखा है आलू साहब का कोई फिल्म? नहीं देखा है ना अभी तक? यहाँ तो बहुत सारे फिल्म में दिखाए गए हैं उनको, 5 फिल्म में दिखाए गए हैं। आज भी है देख लेना कभी। यहाँ मेरे तो घर में भी देख लेना कभी। अगर उनको काम नहीं देखोगे तो समझ में नहीं आएगा वो क्या मास्टरपीस बना के रखे हैं। ठीक
basically in those days 1961 India started its very first official academy formal institution for training professionals in cinema in 1961. This was right under the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting. So there is a background to it. In the 1950s, under the Nehru government, we had great leadership at that time. So they were looking at the situation in India, and they thought, particularly about cinema, they thought cinema was very, had a very low esteem compared to the rest of the world. You were making films, you know, almost in a kind of mode, you know. Every film had to have a popular star, and then every film had to have songs, dancing, a kind of obvious kind of story. You know, there was a formula about what a film should look like. And the whole nation, not one area of India, but all over India, their idea about cinema was conditioned by this kind of films. We produced over and again the same stuff being produced, reproduced. This was the situation. So Nehru's government appointed a committee under S.K. Patil to inquire into the situation that prevailed in the country, and then we wanted in this committee to propose ways and measures of improving the situation in the Indian film industry, how to raise the standards to the international level. That was the idea. So this committee proposed, there was a very important document that they produced. After inquiring into the whole situation, they produced a fantastic report called the S.K. Patil Commission Report. One of the suggestions that it had made was to start a film institute to train professionals in filmmaking. Second was to start a film financing institution to give finance to the production of films, the kind of films which will not get the regular backing of financiers and others. That was the second one. Third one was to start an international film festival in India. And of course, there was also the decision to encourage film societies in all over the country. So these were the main recommendations of the S.K. Patil Commission. Accordingly, in 1961, the Film Institute was set up in Pune. And at that time, there was a lot of criticism why that the Film Institute is not situated in Bombay, which is the capital city of cinema filmmaking in the country. Now, there was a reason, because the idea was not to replicate what was available in Bombay. You know, we had to look at, very interesting, we had to look at cinema from a completely different point of view. This, whether it was planned or it was just happened, we are not very sure. But the actual situation was, the committee found that there was a studio lying absolutely vacant in Pune, called, it's a historically very important studio, the Prabhat Studio. This was owned by some of the very important filmmakers of that time, including the great Shantaram. Some of these very important films were produced there, and there was another very important person called Damde. So some of So they are like classic films like Shah Rukhara, the producer industry. Well, this view has 21 acres of land around it, including a forest, a bone, and so many things that came by. That became to be owned by New Film Institute. That became the venue of the institute. So when I joined Film Institute in 1962, when I went there, I was awed by the prospects of studying there, because this was the place where the great Shantaram worked. That was the main attraction I had. At that time, Shantaram was the unquestioned great master of cinema in Indian cinema. That was the situation. Only later, in 1956, 57, Sanjay made his classic called Padhyar Panchayat. That changed the whole situation. Here, Shantaram had made very interesting films, very socially relevant films, very, very important works. But then he also followed the same formula as the others. He used the same formula, but made films which were of real importance for the society. You know, films like Duniya Na Maane and all that. So he was very, very important to get. But when Sanjay Ray came and made his film, Padhyar Panchayat, the whole situation changed. Suddenly, the whole world sat up to look at the Indian reality reflected in his films, which were very poetic, very real art. From that film onwards, Indian cinema joined that group of films which could be termed art. Till then, we are very low esteem about cinema. Cinema was not even talked about in the universities. You can look at today's situation. Most of the universities today have a department, a section, you know, starting you know, teaching communication in general, where cinema is also included. But in some universities like in Calcutta, Jadavpur University, they had formed an expert committee to examine a proposal to start course in film studies. So the UGC appointed a 3-member committee, of which I was a member, Manata was a member, Shyam Anil was a member. So we went to Calcutta, we had discussions with this very interesting group of teachers there. And then we found it was a very interesting course and we recommended it wholeheartedly. And UGC approved of it, now trustee system. Many of those people who had studied there, they completed a postgraduate course and even doctorates there. I made them in different countries, in the USA, UK, now they are all professors in very important universities for cinema. So that is the way the art in cinema, the art of cinema came to Indian cinema. From Satyajit Ray, you had again another great master from Calcutta again. In fact, all three great masters, according to me, are from West Bengal. First Satyajit Ray, then it was Ravi Prakat, and then the great Manada. All the three of them made very outstanding films. For them, cinema was their religion, their faith, their whole pursuit. You know, that was the kind of culture they inculcated in Indian cinema. So we are, film people like me, just following the opening that they made in the whole film industry. So I happen to make films as you follow your question. I started making, when I passed out of the Film Institute, in fact, my concept about cinema completely changed, got changed with the training there, because there we got to see films made, important films made everywhere in the world, starting from the very first, you know, what you call the flicks, they used to be called flicks, just a few seconds, sometimes a few minutes long films, like the great inventors of cinema were Lumiere and Méliès. Lumiere, you know, there were two brothers, they were called Lumiere brothers. Then each of them followed a different line of astrophotometric photography, the flight to moon and so many things, very interesting work we did in that area. So that's how the films got started. In fact, in India, the history of cinema in fact starts as early as that period. In 1895, this invention was made. The next year, the very next year, these films were shown in a hotel in Bombay. And they are followed by filmmaking efforts in Bombay, particularly in Calcutta, and also in Madras. So for the whole of South, Madras used to be the center of filmmaking, whether it is in films in Malayalam, Telugu, Kannada, or Tamil, all these four languages, the films are made in Madras. For the East, Calcutta was the center. The Assamese, Bengali, Manipuri, Odia, and all those films were being made. Bombay became the place for mostly for Marathi and Hindi films. So, for some strange reason, because Bombay started making films mostly in Hindi, and Hindi was popularized at a time when we were fighting for our freedom. So very naturally, the nationalism was attached to Hindi. So all over India, Hindi films were seen as the Indian film. And we forgot that we had film industries, small film industries in every part of India. And in Assam, for instance, they made films very, very early in India. So later, after independence, after the India had so many regions, so one of the great ideas of Gandhi was to give, you know, each language a different state. The region, that's how the language, the literature, arts, including cinema, flourished in different regions. And films were in Kannada, films in Telugu, films in Tamil, Assamese, Odia, and West Bengal, and Bengali films. All these films started getting made and started getting attention. In fact, the first few films that were made in Bengali were the first to get attention around the world. And that was the contribution of great masters like Ray, Frank, and Sen. So, today, in today's situation, the Marathi cinema is in the forefront, with the promotion being done by the state government. Marathi cinema was really, you know, it had a heyday long back, but then it went into oblivion with the hegemony of the Hindi cinema. Under the big money and popularity of Hindi cinema, Marathi cinema was really struggling for its existence. So today, very special measures adopted for the promotion of Marathi films. Films made with even very small budgets, they make huge money. It's very interesting that they don't really depend on stars for these films, but then they get a wide release. Within 1 week or so, they get back to investment. Then there's a huge amount of money coming as subsidy, all kinds of promotional things. So in the last 10 years' time, we find the most interesting films are being made not in Bengali cinema, not even in Malayalam cinema, but in Marathi cinema. It's very interesting because with enlightened support and leadership, this can happen.
Yeah. Hello, sir. My question was, what interested you to films? How did you go about joining a film institute? Because your background was plays.
Yes.
You were directing a lot of plays.
I've seen so many students in front of me. That's why I thought I should talk about the background. Cinema does not come out of a sudden view. It takes a path. So that's how I came to films, because there was no chance of my coming to make films because my original area of interest was theater. I was a playwright, I used to be acting, I used to be presenting plays, all that. So, cinema was far away from my area of interest, both in my childhood and in my university days. But it was almost an accident because after my graduation I got a job and I was doing that. It was a time when I got bored with the job and I thought this was not going to be in my life. Then I chanced upon this an advertisement calling for admission at the Film Institute. At that time there was no ATI, it was only films, there was no television. Television was not even born.